Hey there guys, my name's Amit and welcome to DevDreamer. Welcome then to lesson number 2 in our HTML series, and this one's all about text editors. Now, what exactly is a text editor? Well, a text editor is basically where we write and compile our HTML. And it's not just used for HTML, it can also be used for other languages, such as PHP, JavaScript, C#, jQuery, and pretty much any other language you can think of can all be written in a text editor. Now, there are many different text editors out there on the market. Some are free, some are paid for. But what you'll find as you start to learn different languages and progress is that choosing a text editor really comes down to personal preference. And that's because all the text editors pretty much do the same job. So what it's going to come down to is what you feel more comfortable with, more confident with, and really what you enjoy the most. Now, in this lesson, I'm going to be sharing with you 4 different text editors. And the reason I'm sharing with you these 4 is because I believe that these are the 4 best text editors currently out there on the market. So then, the first one is Atom. To get it, you simply go to atom.io and you can download it by clicking on this button here. Now, it says download for Mac. That's because I'm on a Mac. If you can't find your download, you can simply click on other platforms here and it will come up with a list of the relevant downloads. Now, the actual text editor, as you can see, you've got a screenshot of it here. It looks really clean and really slick. You can actually scroll down and check out the different features that it comes with. So things such as the built-in package manager and the smart auto-completion. And you can read a bit more about it if you scroll down further. So that's the Atom text editor. The next one we're going to look at is Brackets. Now, Brackets is really cool because it's open source. And again, you can see the screenshot here. Taking a look at the text editor, it looks really clean. If you scroll down, you can see more about the Brackets text editor and look at the different features. One of our favorite features is the live preview button, and we'll take a look at that a bit later on. So that's the Brackets text editor. To download it, you simply click on the download button here. The next one we're going to look at is Sublime Text. Now, Sublime Text is, again, a really nice looking text editor. You can go to sublimetext.com to check it out. And if you scroll down, you can read all about the different features that it has as well. Okay, to download it, you simply click on the download button here. Or you can click on the other platforms button here to check out the download for other platforms. So that's Sublime Text. And finally, we have Visual Studio Code, Microsoft's Visual Studio. So to get it, you simply go to visualstudio.com and you can click on the relevant download button here. And of course, again, you can scroll down and check out all the different features that it has. So go ahead and choose your text editor, get it downloaded to your machine. For this tutorial series, we're going to be using the Brackets text editor. Okay, so go ahead and get it downloaded, or whatever other text editor that you've chosen. I'm actually going to click on cancel here because I've already got it downloaded. And once it's downloaded, open it up and you'll see something that looks like this. Okay then, so what I've got here then is the Brackets text editor. Now it looks blank because there's nothing in there. Let me just very quickly fill something in here. Okay, and this is basically HTML. We'll be looking at the document structure of a HTML file in the next lesson. But yeah, this is the Brackets text editor. Now, remember that live preview button I was talking about? Well, that's actually here. So if I click on this, what that will do is actually bring up a web page. So I'm using Google Chrome. And you can actually make changes to the HTML file here, and it will actually update it and show you that within the web page. So let me just minimize this. And just minimize this as well. Okay, and here in the HTML file, I'm actually just going to type some HTML. Don't worry if you don't know what we're doing right now. We'll be looking at this a bit later on. World. And as you can see, as I was typing it, it actually appeared here as well. Okay, so that's a really cool feature, the live preview button, and it really makes learning a lot quicker because you can actually see the changes that you're making. Okay guys, so go ahead, get your text editor downloaded, and I'll see you in the next lesson where we're going to be looking at the structure of a HTML file. So please subscribe guys, and I'll see you on the next one.